Now though, let's meet the startup CEO.
What we do at Gamsole is we create mobile games and animations. And why do we do this? We create mobile games because we saw a gap, a huge gap, in the mobile gaming industry globally. That little African stories are being told, even in animations. Little African stories are being told. Right from childhood, I've only seen two animation stories that said anything about Africa, Madagascar and Lion King, and they're all about animals. So that whole Africa is about. That is why I came into this, because I want to share African story with the rest of the world. We've been able to find an opportunity globally in order to get global publishers who help us in publishing our games in different regions across the world. And also we've been a prominent publisher on the Windows platform, which has helped us in getting over 10 million downloads of our games. Games are what they are, they're just for fun, really. But games can as well serve other purposes, like education. So you could educate people through games, brain challenge. People can develop their brain capacity through games. But for us, what actually sets our games apart are the literature, the African art, the design, and the kind of story we tell in our games. I studied computer science and mathematics at Abiola University. During my course of study, I was able to represent Nigeria in a lot of competition. I participated in a lot of technology competition that has to do with programming. Because, what made me went to university for computer science and mathematics was because I love programming a lot. So at the age of 15, I started coding even before getting into school. So in 2010, the best competition I've ever been to was the Microsoft Imagine Cup. To a software competition, which I came first, myself and my team came first in Nigeria. Then we had to go and represent the country at the world final with over students from 60 countries globally. It's the world's largest technology contest for students. So, the intensity and the kind of projects people were bringing to the competition made me realize that gaming is actually something that I really love, even though I've not been too exposed to it because of my background. Due to that competition, I was exposed to a lot of gaming projects, and I decided to get back to Nigeria and start developing games. Getting back to Nigeria, coincidentally, Samsung launched a competition called Samsung Developer Challenge, which was challenging app developers to create mobile applications for the Android platform and even the Symbian phones. I remember participating in that competition, and under the entertainment and game categories, my applications came first, and I won some cash money. Then later on, I was Google Student Ambassador. I was Google Student Ambassador later on. Then one of the investment company that Google was supporting was looking for for software developers to invest into. They are called 88MPH. Google is one of their sponsors. So during this activity of being a Google Student Ambassador, I got to hear about them. I applied to them based on my applications that have been publishing to the stores. And through that, they invited me to Nairobi, Kenya, and they invested $15,000 in my business. And that was where I kick-started this company called Gamsole. So yeah, the most fun project I've worked on to this moment will be Downfall also. It's our first 3D game, and it came to life based on the passion of the members of the team. One other one that we haven't completed that I'm really excited about is Gideon. When we released the trailer video, a lot of people were excited about it. The kind of games that we want to be making in future, or that I see myself making in the future, will be a game that can take advantage of fun to use. Can take advantage of fun in order to educate people. Educational games, I think. But in order for you to be able to do that, you need to first master the art of game design and the act of entertaining people, so that when they are learning, they don't feel bored, they don't get bored while learning. So I think in the future, those are the kind of games that I will want to make. The kind of businesses I would love to go into after Gamsole will be a labor intensive business. In IT business, you only require skillful people, very skillful people, which we really don't have in this kind of economy. The number of revenue you're making, you know, can be, it's not proportional to the amount of staffs you have, because you only need very skillful people, and little people can be doing, can be making a lot of money. But for social good, the kind of businesses that we want to go into in future will be businesses that require employing a lot of people, because that way you're helping lives and you're providing jobs for a lot of people too. What I would like to see in my life that will make me know that I finally made it is being, for instance, let's say the highest employer of labor in the whole Africa or something, or one of the highest employer of labor. I think that would be an achievement for me.